subscribe to our YouTube channel, Joy Learning TV.
Hello, students. Welcome to Junior High School Hour on Joy Learning Channel. My name is Isaac Ohene Amankwa, your facilitator for today, and I'm going to take you through ICT. Today, we are going to talk about how to access information. Now, in accessing information, we know definitely we have to go through so many other places to have our information. But before then, at the end of this lesson, we are supposed to be able to define what a website address is. Also, we should also be able to identify the features of a website address. Yes, a website address has its own features. You should be able to identify and browse through hyperlinks and also search information using the search engines. I hope you get it. Now, for this purpose, I would like you to ask mommy and daddy to give you their phones, laptops, and if possible, we need an internet for this lesson. I know you have already been taught what an internet is, and you are very familiar with what an internet is. But let me just ask you, what is an internet? I know my guess is right. You had it. Because I know it's very easy and we all have access to it. Well, for definition, an internet is a technology that allows millions of computers across the world by means of cable or wirelessly to connect to each other. Also, to be able to seek information or access information online, you also have to know what a web browser is. By the way, a web browser, we have always been using it. A web browser is a tool or an application that helps us to surf the internet or go online. Now, let me ask you, what are the sources of information that we can have? Now, formerly, without the internet or without the advent of the internet, most of our information was taken from books, magazines, we have the newsprints, we also have radio and even the television. But with the advent of the internet, we can now have access to it and we have access to all this that we mentioned in the internet also. Now, for the internet or the web-based, we can have access to information through the use of the websites. That is when you know where and specifically you can get your information from. But if you don't know where you can get your information, it's better you use the search engine. I hope we have it. Now, let's continue. Accessing information. We are going to focus our learning for today on the web or accessing information using the internet. Now, formerly, when we started, we mentioned a website address, we mentioned a web browser, we mentioned the internet. Do you have any idea what a web address is or a website address? I can see it sounds a little bit different in your ears because it has recently changed. Now, a website address is simply a line of text, numbers, and characters that identify the location of a page of information on the internet. I know why it sounded so different. Because nowadays, we have all stopped using the word website address and we are using a URL. A URL simply means a universal resource locator. Now, let's look at this website over here. Over here, we have our own myjoyonline.com. That is https://www.myjoyonline.com. Now, if you look on the screens very carefully, you will realize that I have divided it into three sections. We have the prefix or the protocol, which is the HTTPS. Then we have the domain, which is www.myjoyonline. Then the .com will be our extension, or what you call TLD. I know you'll be wondering what a TLD is, but hold on, we'll get to that. Now, when we look at it very carefully, the HTTPS is called a protocol. Now, this protocol is simply allows the internet information from you, the client, or the user, go successfully to a server. And from the server, whatever you requested for is sent back to you. So let's look. What is HTTP? HTTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. But have you noticed that in our website, we had HTTPS? Yes. HTTP and HTTPS are no different. They are one and the same. They just change. Now, the reason for the change of HTTP to HTTPS is simply because formerly, HTTP, when it was used, mostly was attacked by hackers. Most websites were being attacked because they were vulnerable. So in 2009, the whole system changed and it became HTTPS, which simply means Hypertext Transfer Protocol Secured. So, as I said, it is used to transfer data across the internet. Now, let's come to the domain, which is the www.myjoyonline.com. Now, if you look at the www.myjoyonline.com also, I have divided it into three. We have the first one, which is a World Wide Web, that www, which is what we call the subdomain. Then we have myjoyonline.com to be our domain, or what we call the domain name. We have the .com, as I said earlier, TLD. I hope you can see it now. It is simple. It is top level domain. Now, let's take it one after the other. When we come to the domain, the subdomain, it simply tells us where we are getting our information from, or from which section we are moving to, which is our World Wide Web. When we come to myjoyonline, now let's take a website address. Let's take a website address as a location, as we have formerly said, a house. We want to locate Mr. A in a particular house. But now, all we know is his name is Mr. A. Without an address or an identity or a location, it will be very difficult for us to identify where he stays. Am I telling a lie? No, I know I am right. Now, myjoyonline here, which is also known as the domain name, is also the specific location. Now, the domain name, every company has its own domain names. So whatever company it is, or whoever, or an organization, has its own domain name, and which is recognized by all as specifically linked to that organization. Now, when we come to our top-level domains, I know you are not surprised to see .com, but I know you know there are other ones too. These top-level domains simply tell you the purpose of the website. Now, you should know, not all websites can be accessed. Now, we have .com, which is our top level domain, but let's look at this ones too. .net. We have our .net, which is what? Network. We also have the .com we mentioned before is for commercial. We have .org, O-R-G, which is for organization. And we also have .edu, which is for education. We have .gov, which stands for government. We have the .gh, which stands for Ghana. And we also have .mil, which stands for the military. I know you still have a lot. We can have .uk, which stands for United Kingdom. Let's jump on the right. Now, let's go to the internet and see how we can enter a correct website address. Now, we are entering our address, which is www.myjoyonline.com, and let's see what happens. Voila, we have our information. This is a news portal, and all that we need is on this portal. Now, let's try and omit a word or a letter from the website address and see what happens. Now, after mistakenly entering the wrong address, see what happens? We had what? Can't reach this page because it is a wrong address. So, anytime you enter a wrong address, it definitely takes you or gives you the wrong place. Now, did you notice that when we were entering the first one, the correct address, we entered just www.myjoyonline.com? And did you notice that HTTPS automatically appeared? Yes, it is what we call auto-entry. Now, it has been programmed in every web browser such that immediately you enter MyJoy or you enter any website address without HTTPS, automatically it pops up. Okay, let's go back. Now, if you look at this page very carefully, you realize that anytime I take my mouse to where a picture is, you see a hand. That's the hand pointer, or what we call the link pointer. When I move to any phrase of word, it still gives me the same thing. When I move to a place where there is nothing, it just gives me a mouse pointer. Okay. Now, if you look at this page again, I'm taking my mouse again to this place, and what we have? A link pointer. Now, what happens if I should click this? Let's see. it opened another page. This is what we call a hyperlink. What is a hyperlink? I know you should be asking yourself that question, but a hyperlink is very simple. A hyperlink can be defined as an electronic location. It's simply or similar to a website, but this time it can be found in the web pages. They help us jump to pages or web pages or even files sometimes. So normally what happens is that in hyperlinks, they can appear in blue links or blue words when they are found within a sentence. Let's have a look at this. This is an example of a hyperlink. If you see very carefully, you realize that we have domain name system here, which appears in blue. We also have a website, which appears in blue. We have string, which appears in blue. And there are other blue lettered in our documents. And the others are all black. This simply means that the blue ones are what we call the hyperlinks. And anytime we click on any of them, we will be jumped to either a new page or a file. Now, on our web page, we realized that anytime we took our mouse pointer close to a picture, it gave us the link pointer. Why? Because it's also an example of a hyperlink. Now, hyperlinks comes in four. We have the word, we have the phrase, we have the picture, and sometimes we have what we call the headline. In this picture, we have a website which is just a single word. So that can be called a word type of hyperlink. And we also have what we call the domain name system, which is also in a phrase form. So we can call that one the phrase type of hyperlink. Let's look at this. Under this picture, there is a headline over there. Immediately you click, or when we took our mouse there, it gave us the link pointer. And this is what we call the headline type of hyperlink. On our right, we also have the picture type, which when we click also can jump us to a different location, like we saw. Now, let's look at how we can open a hyperlink in a different window. Sometimes we might be reading a document where we don't need to go to a different page, but we need to find or access a hyperlink. So what do? We have to open a different window for that one. So let's observe. This is our page. Now, we are going to open this very one, the one with the president, on a different page. And this is how we are going to do. First, you right click. Then, when the drop down menu comes, you select open link in new window. Now, you realize there's an open link in new tab. You can also do that, and they give you the same results. So let's see, a new window. Now, a new browser, a window browser is open for me, and I have my link opened. So it is very simple as that. Should we go over again? So these are the points again. Right click on hyperlink. Then you choose new window from the drop down menu. So let's watch it again. This time we are going to choose a different picture. we have our drop-down menu. Then we come to new window. Marvelous. We have done it and we have had it right. Isn't that simple? ICT is very interesting. But hey, do you know something? Anytime you do something on the computer, on the phone, or on the laptop, and you have it wrong, don't be worried. It's simple. Just go back and retry. You will not damage it. Don't be afraid of the computer. Always get close to it. Now, if we realize from the beginning, we mentioned that to seek information or to access information, we can do that through website addresses or search engines. Let's talk a little bit about search engines. Now, most of you have been using search engines, of which you know, or probably you have no idea they are called search engines. Am I not right? Now, search engines are what we call softwares or programs which that searches for and identifies items in a database that corresponds to a specific keyword you, the client or the user, have keyed in. A search engine can also be defined as a system that is designed to assist users locate information on the internet. But hey, you should be the one seeking for the information. You should be the one entering the information. If you enter the wrong information, you get the wrong information. So it is simple. Garbage in, garbage out. When using a search engine, you are advised to enter specific keywords, but not general. Because if you enter general keywords, it will be a problem. You have a whole lot of garbage coming to you. Now, when we come to search engines, we have different types of search engines. But for the purpose of this lesson, I will not go deep into search engines, but I will just give you a gist about what or the types of search engines we have. We have the ones called the index. We have the ones called the meta crawlers. And we also have the ones... So let's keep this to index and meta crawlers. Now, what they do is that the index picks information from websites every 4 hours. So there might be a new information which those index might not have. So when you go to a search engine, which is an index search engine, what will happen is that you key in information and you might not get an accurate information. What about the meta crawlers? The meta crawlers are the super ones. They are the types that when they pick information from everywhere and they are updated systematically. Now, anytime we enter information in a meta crawler type of search engine, automatically it gives us the best answer or the most accurate answer we ever wanted. Can you guess what or an example of a meta crawler? You are correct. Google, as we all know, is an example of a meta crawler. Now, let's look at examples of search engines. Examples of search engines include Google, as we all have already mentioned. We have Yahoo. We have MSN.com. We have Bing. We have Lycos. We have web crawlers. Now, you realize that I mentioned meta crawlers. Web crawler is also another type of a search engine. But, hey, you know what to choose. Anytime you want a search engine, you can choose from any of this list. Now, let's see how search engines work. We are going to use Google to search for information. Now, follow me to the computer and let's see. we are opening a new tab and we input our website address, which is www.google.com. This is our search engine. Now, we have our search box here. So we are going to input our the information we are looking for. We are going to search for domain name. And let's see what comes out. Now, you realize that when I inputted domain name, it gave me a whole lot of list. We can scroll and we get a lot of information on domain name. But hey, we have to choose the best one. Remember, always the best result is at the top. So, the first answer or the first response that we have, that is domain.com. It might not be our answer. Remember, I said we have to be specific about what we are looking for. I never entered meaning of domain name. I just entered domain name. And look at the answer it gave me. It said I can register a domain. That is not the information we are looking for, right? Now, let's go back. And scroll to our results. Now, I think we have a proper one or the right one we wanted. That is found on wikipedia.com, domain name, the definition. And it says a domain name is an identification string that defines a realm of administrative autonomy. Well, the definition seems to be too big, but don't worry. Whenever we enter the correct keyword, we will get the correct answers. Now, with all that we have done, I want you to try this for me. It's just a short question, which I know within 10 minutes, you should be able to finish. The question one says, what is a website address? I know you know it and you'll be able to write. The question two says, list the three parts of a website address. Question three, list three examples of top level domains. Question four, specialized programs that assist users to locate information on the internet are called? You know the answer. List three examples of search engines. So, the time starts now. Let's take 10 minutes. Okay. Okay, I know you are done with your work. Now, let's check our answers. Now, the first one says, a website address is a line of text, number, or characters that identify the location of a page of information on the internet. Very simple, and I know you had it. The second question, the three parts of the website address. They are the prefix or the protocol, the domain, and the top level domain. If you wrote TLD, well, you are correct. But next time, write the full meaning, top level domain. The third one, specialized program for searching for information on the internet. The answer is a search engine. The fourth question that requires us to write out three examples of search engines are Google, Yahoo, MSN. We can write Lycos, we can write web crawlers, and any other search engine you write is correct. Now, if you had all these questions, all these answers correct, bravo, you did really well. And you were a nerd. Well, I'm also a nerd. If you had three of the questions, sure, you have really done well. Now, so soon we are coming to the end of this lesson. And I know that we have already spoken and we've learned about what a website address is. And I've defined it just now, that it's a line of text, number, or and characters that identify the location of a page of information on the internet. Also, we spoke about hyperlinks, and we said they normally come in blue text colors, and sometimes they can be in a word form, a phrase, even a picture or a headline. We spoke also about HTTP and HTTPS, and we said they are one and the same, but just that it has been upgraded or a security feature has been added which prevents people from having access to your information which they are not supposed to have access to. So if you realize, if you try and enter any website address which HTTP, what it will tell you is that it is insecure. That means your information might be stolen through that website. So be careful the website you attend to. We also spoke about search engines, and we said they are tools or programs that help us search for information on the internet. One more thing. I want us to go through our websites again and enter them and see our results. You know, practice makes perfect. Let's move to our laptops. We are going to enter, and this time, a new website address. We are going to enter now. You realize that we already have a page on our computers. Now, to open a new link, if you don't want to close the old one, you realize that there is a plus sign close to the headline. Now, immediately you take your mouse to that place, you realize it is written new tab. Now, if you click on the new tab, what happens is that it opens a new page for you to have access to your information. Now, after opening the new tab, we go to our address bar, then we enter. Well, this time I'm going to enter the website address of the University of Ghana, and let's see what happens. www.ug.edu.gh. Voila. This is the website address for the University of Ghana. Now, you realize that this time we have EDU, not EDU alone, but also we have GH attached to it. This means that it is specifically linking the University of Ghana to an educational institution which is found in Ghana. In some other countries, you can have them as maybe www.example.edu.uk or edu.ca, which simply means Canada. Now, let's see. Let's try entering a wrong one and see what happens again. This time, we are going to omit one of the dots and see. Now, it happened again. We are still having, can't reach this page. Why? Because there is no separator between EDU and the dot and the GH, which simply shows that that is not a TLD. Because we don't know any TLD called EDUGH. So, next time when you are entering your website address, make sure you are very specific with what you are entering and you enter them correctly. Else, you might not get your information. Let's try one more time with a search engine. This time, let's try bing.com. Now, this is our bing.com. This time, we are going to be specific with our information. We are now going to search for, let's get into science, plant cell. You realize that we have so many other searches which people have done, but be specific with what you are looking for. If you are looking for the diagram, if you are looking for the difference between the plant cell and the animal cell, or just the diagram as a labeled diagram for the plant cell or the structure, you can choose any of them. Now, let's take the diagram. So we go for plant cell diagram labeled. It's someone's search. Here we are. Now, you will note that we do not only have text but also pictures. Search engines do not just give text or just text information, but they give images, videos. So when you want for Google or Bing or any other search engine, if you want videos, you just choose the video menu and it gives you video on what you are searching for. Here are the videos. If you want to watch any video, you can go there. If you come to images, you have all the images on the plant cell. Here they are. What about when you want to watch joy learning in the house? Well, or probably when you travel anywhere else in the country and you want to watch joy learning on your phone. Let's try that one. For that one, we have to, let's put a search to it and see what happens. So we have to clear our search box and type in joy learning TV. These are images from Joy Learning TV, but why don't we go to videos so that we can view our lessons? We can see that we have core mathematics, we have essay club finale, we also have English language comprehension, we have a whole lot, even the competition, the winners. You can see the pictures over there. They're very interesting. So we are going to try one and see. We're going to pick, let's scroll down. Now, you realize that since we are not specific with a topic or subject, we have a whole lot of videos. So if I want an ICT lesson, then I should add ICT to our search. But today, we are just going for mathematics. When you click, then it opens or it redirects you to the main website of that video. Then it plays it for you. Wasn't that interesting? I know you have learned something new. Remember, in searching on the search engines, you have to be very, very specific with your data, or else you get a whole lot of garbage. So we'll end this lesson here today. Till we meet again, it's Joy Learning saying bye-bye.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel, Joy Learning TV.